So for our last shock absorber related problem, we're going to be talking about damping. So far when we've been talking about simple harmonic motion, we've been assuming that the motion just continues forever in this nice sinusoidal pattern. In real life, however, we have to deal with things like friction and losses to heat when the springs move up and down. So in real life, oscillations often look a lot more like this, where they start out with a large amplitude, just like before, but the longer they continue to oscillate, the smaller their amplitude becomes as they lose energy. And this phenomenon is called damping. Now, there are actually several different types of damping, but for our problem, let's only consider this type of damping, which we call underdamping, where the amplitude decays in this kind of exponential pattern. All right, now we're ready to move on to the problem. So suppose that our car here is damped such that it loses 20.6% of its energy per cycle. So that means that after a car hits, say, a bump, it'll oscillate with some initial energy, but after each cycle, a cycle being one pattern like this, it will lose 20.6% of its energy. So looking at this situation a bit more mathematically, we get this equation, that the energy of the oscillator after n cycles is equal to 0.94, which is 1 minus 20.6%, to the n times the initial energy, E0. So what this equation is saying is that after 3 cycles, for example, the amount of energy left in the oscillator will be equal to 0.794 to the third power times E0. So my question for you is, how many cycles does it take? What's this value n in order for the amplitude to decay to 1/2 of its original value? So if, for example, you said the answer was 4, that would mean that after 4 complete oscillations, after 4 cycles, the amplitude of this oscillation would be reduced to 1/2 its original value. So put your answer here and round your answer to the nearest whole cycle. So don't say 3.5, say 4, for example. So as a hint when you're solving this problem, you should keep in mind that the energy of the oscillator is directly proportional to the amplitude squared, not just the amplitude. So keep that in mind when you're using this equation here. Good luck.